ich bin's wieder, Case und neue Haram, hier bei meinem Let's Play von Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney Spirit of Justice. Beim letzten Mal haben wir die dritte Episode dieses schönen Teils beendet. Und es setzt so langsam aber sicher nehmen wir uns dem Ende. Doch bevor wir uns damit beschäftigen können, wie jetzt die gesamte Krise um das Rechtssystem in Kurain bewältigt wird,
kommt ein Filler.
Man will ihm aber zugutehalten, dass es zumindest einer der Filler ist, der keine Investigation beinhaltet. Es ist einfach nur eine Gerichtsverhandlung und dann ist Schluss. Und ja, er wird gehasst von vielen, die es gespielt haben. Nicht nur, weil das halt so Filler ist und sowas und ja, sondern weil ich auch mitbekommen habe, dass Leute, die es gespielt haben und sich überhaupt nicht mit japanischer Kultur auseinandergesetzt haben, dezent Schwierigkeiten bekommen haben, diese Episode überhaupt voranzukommen, den Fall zu lösen und sowas, weil sie ja einige Sachen über die auftretenden Begriffe einfach nicht wissen können. Und dann lassen sie ihre Wut an dem Spiel aus, ungerechterweise. Mhm. Ja, deshalb will ich vorab mal ein paar Sachen erklären. Also ein paar Begriffe, die auftreten und dann, damit zumindest dieses Verständnis da ist. Gut. Also als erstes einmal Rakugo. Eine Unterhaltungsart mit Monologen, vorgeführt von einer Person. Ja, es steht nur eine Person auf der Bühne und der erzählt per Monolog eine Geschichte. Mit einem schnicken Twist am Ende und ja. Darin soll es auch übrigens, um diese Kunstform soll es übrigens hier auch gehen. Also Rakugo. Und dann gibt es noch die zwei japanischen Nudelsorten, Soba und Udon. Der gravierende Unterschied bei diesen Sachen ist, Udon besteht, wie man das, glaube ich, von normalen Nudeln kennt, aus Weizenmehl. Sie sind auch etwas dicker. Soba dafür ist sehr dünn gehalten und bestehen aus Buchweizen. Merken? Dann die Karutas. Das ist ein japanisches Kartenspiel. Braucht man sonst nicht viel wissen. Sake sollte vielleicht auch einigen Begriff sein, das ist einfach ein japanischer Reiswein, was auch sehr oft als Zusatz benutzt wird, um irgendwas zu kochen, damit halt so eine Art kleiner Geschmacksverstärker und sowas, ne? Sieht man ja zum Beispiel, wenn man irgendwie Wein reintut. Und schließlich Manju, eine Süßigkeit mit unterschiedlichen Art der Zubereitung und Füllung. Ja, das wär's dann. Wer es nicht mitbekommen hat, nochmal zurückspulen, aufschreiben. Ich wiederhole es nicht nochmal, ich bin jetzt ein böser Lehrer. So, damit das jetzt erledigt ist, starten wir mal ausgerüstet. So, und nicht wundern, meine Stimme ist ein bisschen am Arsch. Episode 4, Talabot Storyteller. Shisho's dead? No. Do you think he did it? Oh no. If he did it, then what do we do? Hey, pull yourself together. Don't worry. I have an idea. Ich finde es immer noch witzig, wenn bei der Typewriter dieser eine Melo kommt. Ich komme mir so bekannt vor, aber ich komme wieder nicht darauf, von woher. Schlimm. Okay. Also. 13. Mai, 9.45 Uhr, District Court, Defendant Lambie Nummer 6. Nochmal einen Schluck nehmen. Ich hasse das Gefühl, irgendetwas im Hals stecken zu haben und man kriegt es einfach nicht runtergeschluckt. What the heck? Who brings the defendant to his own trial late? Plus, the request was so last minute, I didn't even have a chance to talk with my client. He's late for a very important date. My name is Athena Sykes. Armed with analytical psychology and a full arsenal of legal know-how, I'm a fully competent defender of the Right Anything Agency. Though I wish my client would shut up already. The trial's about to start.
It appears we made it just in time.
Where have you been? The trial's about to start, Simon!
You needn't to get so worked up, Athena. His boldness can wait.
Simon, du Spast! Hi! Den kennt man doch noch! Aus Duel Destinies! Hi! There's no way he'd wait for me! And besides, why would I want to start off on the wrong foot with him right out of the gate?
Dealing with such matters is part of being a lawyer, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, well, covering for your lateness is not.
Still got a rank amateur, I see.
This is Simon Blackwell. He might not look it, but he's actually a prosecutor and a psychology specialist. He and I go way back, as for our shared specialization in psychology. We're both the siblings of the same person, so to speak, but he's kinda my senior, I guess. Weil Blackwell bekannterweise die Psychologie bei Athenas Mutter studiert hat. Und das wendet er so schön auch vor Gericht an. Simon bist der Beste. Du Spast. But twisted sense of humor or no, I wish he'd stop treating me like a child all the time.
So, we're all right doing our justice to him.
Mr. Wright is abroad, and Apollo's helping Trucy with her magic show. Didn't I tell you?
The what? So neither one of them are here? Leaving you to take this on alone?
Yep.
You gods. Call right Donald back. It's not too late.
Oh, no, not too late at all. He would only need to know how to teleport.
Very well. Then it will suffer for justice, Donald. Go grab him by the horns or drag him here.
Apollo's literally in the middle of a show, Simon. You may not want to admit it, but I've got what it takes to take on this case. Just leave this to me and go watch from the gallery.
As you defend the relative spectacular fashion.
No, as I win the heck out of this trial. I'll be okay, promise. So wipe that look off your face already, will you? Anyway, I take it the guy behind you is?
Yes, he's your... He's asleep again. Hoi, Bucky, wake up!
Yeah! Ow! What did that for, Simmy? Hi. Lass bloß nicht deine Platten fallen. Who is this little schickity?
She's your lawyer, such as it were. I'd say she's more green than yellow, however.
Danke. Lawyer, she shouldn't look at it, is she? Is she like a fellow apprentice or something?
Something like that. I've known her longer than I've known you. You could say we're born to one another.
Oh, okay. Well then, guess I'd better call you Miss Chickadee then.
Simon, this guy's not only rude, but he is three sheets to the wind at his own trial. I know we just met, but I'm about ready to give him a piece of my mind.
Do as you will. Just save it for after the trial.
Miss Chickadee.
Don't call me that!
How do you do? Simi is an old friend of mine. I'm the fourth generation head chef of Wet Soba. Wet noodle number four, Bucky Wet. Nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too, Mr. Wet. So he can pull himself together when he wants to.
Yeah, but nur wenn er will.
If only the trial wasn't starting in a few minutes.
Having been accused of a murder that only occurred yesterday, I'm afraid it's taking a toll on the poor boy.
And you happened to be there at the theater where it all happened too, right? They said they found a Rakugo storyteller murdered in his dressing room.
Indeed. The victim, master storyteller Typhoon Tornado, was a longtime patron of Wet Soba. Master Tornado had been looking after Bucky ever since Wet Noodle number 3 passed away.
I see, so the victim was kind of like a father to the defendant, huh?
That stupid old fat. Like a father? No way. I was always dishing my soba.
How dare you speak ill of him? Running your mouth like that is why they suspected you of his murder in the first place. Now pull yourself together. Number 3 must be rolling in his grave.
What, Simi? The police. None of them believes me. They won't listen to me.
It looks like he's still in shock from the whole ordeal. Don't worry, Mr. Wet. Everything's gonna be alright. I'm going to defend you with everything I've got. You're in good hands now.
I mean, you believe me, ma'am?
Of course! No matter what, I'll believe in you to the very end.
Gee whiz, Miss Chickadee.
Now, come on. I need you to shape up. Just like those old damned noodles of yours.
Yeesh, ma'am. I so much the freshest... So viel zum Thema frisch.
Mr. Wet!
Bucky, you great big pillock.
So, how exactly do you know this guy?
I used to frequent Wet Soba, and still do, in fact. So I've known him since he was a lad. That's why his father and Master Tornado were always so good to me.
I didn't know you liked Soba so much, Simon.
I wouldn't expect one such as you, who eats meat slapped between slabs of bread, to understand the delicate taste and the subtle texture imparted by bucket wheat's flour.
Hey, that's just rude!
But I digress.
I'm all about flavor and subtlety and stuff.
If I let Wet Soba end like this, I'll never be able to face number 3 or Master Tornado in the next life.
Ah, I see. And that's why you came to me. You wanted somebody you could trust.
It was never my intention to ask you.
I'll show him. I'll show him I can handle it just fine.
Well, I believe it's just about time.
What? But we haven't even properly discussed the case yet.
What's the matter? You look nervous, Athena. Don't tell me you're chickadeeing out.
I'm just trembling with the excitement of battle, that's all! Auf geht's, let's do this! Come on, Mr. Wet! Get up off the floor! We've got a case to win!
Yes, Miss Chickadee, I'm gonna do my best.
Wet soba, wet soba, wet soba, wet soba, wet soba.
This? Hello, two balls of noodles. Sorry, sir, no can do. Kinda busy at the courthouse. Huh? They who up? Okay, let's do this.
He is not going to do himself or his case any favors like this, Simon. Maybe we should let him go get some rest somewhere.
Let me rest? Maybe if I wear a limp or regular flour rather than minerals. And I'm fresh like my soba, and all that soba stuff rushed is all about this refreshes. When grind the pack of wheat seeds fresh cut the... Danke.
Scheiße!
He's blacked out.
Oh boy, I just knew something like this would happen. Simon, what are these three freshers of soba he was talking about?
Wenn man von diesem einen Satz spricht. Grind the buckwheat seeds fresh, cut the duff fresh, and boil the noodles fresh.
Ah.
Okay, also, die Buchweizen, was macht man nochmal mit denen?
Vergessen, wie der Begriff heißt.
Und dann den Teig frisch schneiden und die Nudels dann frisch kochen.
Nudels, was? Nudeln, boah.
First, buckwheat seeds or groats are grown to make buckwheat flour. Then dove made with his flour is cut with a large rectangular knife into noodles. And finally the buckwheat noodles are boiled. Each step is done immediately one after the other so that the soba is fresh when eaten.
Ah, so that's what he meant. I wouldn't want him to make me any soba right now, so that's for sure.
Athena, there's no time for idle chatter. You need to get into the courtroom now. Just remember, as a prosecutor, I will be unable to let you hand. So don't expect any help from my court.
There you go, treating me like I'm incompetent again. For your information, I wasn't planning on asking you for help anyway. Just you wait, Simon. I'll show you.
Yeah, salty Athena.
Mr. Wright and Apollo may not be here, but that's alright. I can do this on my own.
Okay.
Dann geht's mal endlich los. Hat auch lange genug gedauert.
13. bei 9.50 Uhr, das ist die Courtroom Nummer 4.
Court is now in session for the trial of Bucky Wet!
The defense is ready, Your Honor!
The prosecution is fully prepared, Your Honor.
What's this? No prayer to start prosecutor Sadmadi?
That is correct, Your Honor. To expedite the proceedings, I completed them beforehand in the lobby.
How very thoughtful of you! By the way, what brings you back to this country?
Chief Prosecutor Edgeworth himself called on me to handle this case. Besides, I have a debt to repay. And though my opponent is yet a callow thing, I have no cause for sending her down to hell.
If you have a score to settle, it's with Apollo, not me! But more importantly, I'm not a callow thing! I'm a qualified and capable attorney!
Then what is that yellow attire if not proof of your nature, you small spring chick? Maturity, meine ich, pass auf einmal. Now cease your shrill chirping.
No, no, Prosecutor Sapmadi! She's still only a teenager! Please go easy on her!
Great! Now even the judge has given me the kid treatment!
Very well. Shall we begin, Your Honor?
Yes! I suppose we should! Now then, Prosecutor Sapmadi, please give your opening statement!
I'll show them what I can do! They'll be sorry they underestimated me!
Certainly. Let the last rites of the victim commence. The incident is believed to have occurred at around 4 PM yesterday, May 12th, at a storyteller's theater called Kuluk Kulute. The victim was a great master of the Tornado School of Rakugo, or comedic storytelling. His name was Taifu Tornado. The scene of the murder was the theater's dressing room. It is accessible via the staff entrance hallway and has an inner-outer sliding door.
Schön! Herr Robert?
The estimated time of death is between 2 PM and 5 PM. The cause of death is suffocation, though how the victim suffocated is yet to be determined. The autopsy found nothing unusual in his lungs or stomach, and there's no murder weapon. I will now submit the incident report to the court.
Danke. Und danke. Prosecutor Sapmadi, how can you name Mr. Wet as the culprit? When you don't know the victim was killed, or even with what?
Well, it is true that the weapon and precise method are as yet unknown. The accused is the only one who had the opportunity to commit the murder. I will explain this assertion in further detail as we continue.
I guess this means he has some kind of evidence to present.
Now, would the accused care to plead his case?
Come to think of it! Where is the defendant, Miss Sykes?
Sorry, Your Honor. But I'm afraid Mr. Wet isn't feeling very well and is resting in the infirmary.
Surely it is a lack of a clear conscience that impedes him from facing this court.
Great! Starting off on the wrong foot already!
Mr. Wet is the head chef of a soba shop frequented by the victim. On the day of the incident, Mr. Wet went to the theater at the victim's request. Taifu Tornado was a connoisseur of soba, as you can see in these photographs. He was apparently making soba himself in his dressing room that very day. The soba found at the scene is likely the soba he himself made there.
Blacking soba is one thing, but making it in a theater dressing room's a bit much, no?
Mr. Tornado truly had a passion for Soba, didn't he? For a man like that to be murdered by a Soba chef is simply unthinkable!
And yet, the accused had ample motive. For in the victim's safe, we discovered the deed on the accused shop. Mr. Wet was to inherit Wet Soba when he lost his father recently. However, it's believed the victim stole the shop's deed during the transfer process. The prosecution believes the accused killed the victim in order to get the deed back.
Okay.
A murder over the deed to a shop! That doesn't sound like a plausible motive!
So that's what this case is about. I wish Simon had filled me in a little better. I could have contributed more than just 1,000 buckets of cold sweat if he had.
Depends. From your demeanor, I gather you know very little about the details of this case.
Well, you see...
You are dishonoring the soul of the victim by appearing in the courtroom unprepared. You are an embarrassment to your profession, your putrid egg yolk.
I'm sorry! Apollo's a red pepper and now I am an egg yolk? I've only just started, I've already been demoted from Spring Chick!
I'm ready to call my witness, Your Honor.
Zu meiner Verteidigung! Ja, ich hab die Information erst jetzt bekommen, also... Hush!
Let us listen to the words of one who was present when the crime was discovered.
Someone who was there when the victim's body was found?
Marimo! Witness, please take the stand!
Und das ist...
Witness, please state your name and occupation.
Simon Blackwell, prosecutor.
Prosecutor Blackwell! You didn't tell me you were going to take the stand!
There simply wasn't time.
What a shame, Prosecutor Blackwell. Had you shared the damning scene you witnessed beforehand with the defense, we could have moved this trial along and saved the victim's soul that much faster.
The damning scene? What in the world did Simon see?
Prosecutor Zatmaldi, was it? Before I give my testimony, there's something I'd like to confirm.
By all means.
This case involves Rakugo, a very traditional form of Japanese comedic storytelling. Do you have enough knowledge of this art form to handle the case competently?
Are you implying that I'm not qualified for this case?
Not yet. I'm simply trying to ascertain your familiarity with the topic from now.
It is a prosecutor's duty to learn the background of any case he takes on. I did some research on the Rakugo last night, and have grasped the overall idea of it.
How much could you possibly grasp in a single night?
Complete Wikipedia?
Rakugo is a form of entertaining storytelling that originated in the lab of Japan, and then the storyteller sits alone on the stage with only a fan and a towel as... And the Rakugo artist tells long, whimsical stories giving each character a distinct voice. This traditional art was originally invented by monks to make sermons more interesting. Are you satisfied? If not, I could explain the 12 types of endings to such stories. Or shall I perform the famous story of Yugemo instead?
Oh, it appears you have put in a bit of study.
Your acknowledgement is most welcome, Prosecutor Blackwell.
I can see why you are known for being quite thorough in your research, Prosecutor! No, I would love to see you perform that story you mentioned, if you don't mind!
If that is your honest request, you can.
Your Honor, could we please get back to the trial?
Oh, right! Of course! I nearly forgot!
Mano! Seriously? Of all the things to use to forget?
Now then, back to the case! Prosecutor Blackwell! Please tell this court what you witnessed!
Oh ja, bitte. Bevor jetzt noch wieder endlos lange Reden kommen.
I went to the theater yesterday and arrived at approximately 4 p.m. I went straight to Master Tornado's dressing room to say hello. Bucky went into the dressing room thereafter, only to come storming out a while later. Master Tornado stood at the second window, apparently then entered the room soon after. That's when Wendo discovered Master Tornado's body.
Now, wait just a minute here, Prosecutor Blackwell! What testimony like that? You're practically accusing Mr. Wet of the crime!
All I can do is state what I saw. I can't help how it appears. But a qualified and capable attorney such as you should be able to dispatch with it, right?
Well, yeah, duh. Alright, I guess I better start by giving all the info out of him that I can.
Well, aber Simon hat schon recht. Er kann ja nichts dafür, wenn er gesehen hat, was er gesehen hat. Und wenn es so aussieht, und da können wir ihn ja sicherlich glauben, dann... Ja. Also dann,
Kreuzverhör!
What Simon saw. Was Simon, du Spaß, gesehen hat. Okay, fangen wir damit an, dass wir diese Aussage angreifen.
Prosecutor Blackwell, what did you get to the... What did you go to the theater
Oh, was ist das für ein Satz?
For the theater for in the first place?
I went because I had received an invitation from Master Tornado. Here, see for yourself. It was a special show commemorating Miss Junior the Civil Wendell's promotion. It was also an occasion to announce the boy's succession to the stage name of Wendell the 20th. The two.
Oh, the second! Römische Zahlen auf Englisch! Furchtbar! Wendell the second! So!
So what exactly does it mean to succeed to a stage name?
You really don't know, do you? In the performing arts, name succession is when an artist inherits a predecessor's name. Predecessor.
Bah!
I see. So there was another Wendell Rakugo artist before, and this is Ibel succeeded him, huh? And what exactly did your invitation say?
It contained a simple letter of salutation and an outline of the show's program.
It appears Typhoon Tornado was going to perform Tokisoba or Time Soba! He's famous for his masterful pantomime of eating soba, using only his fat as a prop! And Wendell was a performed Soba Sei or Soba Glutton! A soba themed show, I see!
It seems you know a thing or two about Rakugo yourself, you boy. This. The first to perform was the senior of the Civil, Gaido, followed by Wendell. And lastly, Master Tornado.
Das ist wirklich heilige Infos. Danke, Simon!
I see. So that's why you happened to be at the Storyteller's Theater yesterday. So what happened after you arrived?
Ich könnte jetzt weiter mit dem Kreuzverhör machen, aber ich bin schon weit über dem Zeit. Nur weil jetzt diese Introduction so extrem lange gedauert hat. Aber zumindest hatten wir jetzt etwas Gameplay. Das ist ja schon mal was. Gut, egal ob positive oder negative Wertung, wir haben gesehen, das war's von meiner Seite. Wir sehen uns das nächste Mal wieder. See ya, guys!